Hello friends, good morning and welcome to another new topic which I'm going to start today. And after this topic, whenever this topic will complete, I am going to conduct your exams. Please friends, with me only you have to complete this chapter. Whatever topic I'm completing daily, same topic related, all information you collect and complete your question answers and complete your all type of assignments related to this chapter. Textual question answers is topic. If you have any query in doubt, personally call me or message me. I will solve your doubts. Correct, friends? So please start chapter number 3. Start to write your fair eco notebook, okay? And if you are going to find any answer and you are facing any problem, then you personally message me or call me. I will solve your doubts and your queries. And friends, whenever I will complete your third chapter, then after I am going to conduct your again class test. And that time you remember that time carefully you join by the Google Docs and you complete your assignment at the time. Because of last time when I have conducted your exam, that time so many students have not written their roll number. So I'm also confused who has written what. How I can give marks? I have 189. These answer books. In total number of students are 162. And here I have checked this all assignment which you have submitted by Google Docs. These are 189. So how it can be possible? Some students have written roll number. Only few students have written roll number. What about others? Few students have not written roll number. So how I can identify who is who? Okay. That means if I will select any type of answer book which you submitted, but I cannot identify it is who. So please friends, whenever you are going to attain next class test, that time first of all you have to fill your roll number section with roll number. Okay. Second thing is, whenever you are going to start your question paper, first of all you have to complete it, again you reach it. Then you submit, not before that. So my students have not written roll number, not written section, and without any full completed assignment also they have submitted. So I will not check that this all. And after this chapter, we will complete this chapter after some days, maybe 25 we will complete it. So 26 I will conduct your again class test, which will be related to chapter number 1, 2, and 3. All three, not only one, chapter number 1, 2, 3. Correct, friends? Only 20 marks, not more than 20. Only 20 marks, but chapter number 1, 2, 3, there's all three I will include on 25th. Okay, friends, so be ready for that. And on 25th, I will complete, before that, I will complete our full this chapter. Okay, friends, so please, you have also complete your this last third chapter with me. Don't wait for next. So hello friends, we will start today increase and decrease in demand. In this topic, I said that we have this two type, expansion and contraction in demand, increase and decrease in demand. In expansion and contraction demand, I said that when all other factors are constant due to change in price, what type of changes occur in demand, these are known as expansion and contraction. That means due to false price, demand will be expand from 3 units to 5 units or 6 units. Due to raise the price, demand will be contract from 3 to 2 or 2 to 1. But you remember this thing, in that case, curve will not change. Curve will say D, only this curve. D0, you can say D0, only one curve will there. No any change, the curve will not shift, only and only that point of that, okay, that point will be, initially point will be changed from A to C or A to B. I said last day, okay, in my last lecture I said same thing, that is expansion contraction. Contraction that means, jo ki kam hota hai, okay. 3 units से उसकी डिमांड कम होकर के 2 पे चले जाती है या 1 पे चले जाती है, दैट इज कॉन्ट्रेक्शन. एक्सपांशन दैट मीन्स वॉट, ड्यू टू फॉल्स द प्राइस demand will be expand from 3 to 4, 4 to 5. It's expansion of demand. I hope you all have understood, so no need to repeat again. Come to our next and new topic. It's related to increase and decrease in demand. In these trends, when one factor or some other factors, you can say other than price, if one factor or some other factors, they other than price, changed in the favor of demand of a good, then there is an increase in demand. Listen and properly listen what I say. I said when one factor or some factors other than price, not price. You know, we have two type of factors, price and other factors. So here we are just thinking it, right? We are not discussing about price. Price we have discussed in contraction and expansion. Here we are discussing about other factors. Other factors, that means what? Income of the consumer, okay? Then test and preference, price of related good, future expectation regarding price and population. These other factors related topic we are discussing here. So if other than price, maybe one factor or few factors change in the favor of demand, change in the favor of demand of a good, then there is increase in demand with this cause. The curve will shift from, initially curve to left side, initially curve will be shift from left to right. If you are sitting this side, you will see left to right, this curve will shift, correct? So when one factor or few factors other than price change in the favor of demand of a good, then there is an increase in demand which is caused by rightwards. Look at here, D1. It is our initially point. In your curve, you can see, in your curve, if you have textbook, you can open and or you can see on the screen, okay? On the screen, this curve, D1, I'm saying about this curve, okay? And here it is the price of a commodity in rupees, demand of a commodity in rupees, but price is constant, it is 3 and 3. What is the price? This one, 3 and 3. This one price. So, here price is constant, due to that reason it is a curve. And it is a straight line. What is line? A straight line. You can see here, it's a straight line from here to this side. Correct ones? So, on this curve, I can say, on this curve, price is constant, that is 3 rupees. So we have drawn a single line this side. This one line we have drawn here. This one line is fixed. Okay, which is on this? 3. It is price. So it is fixed, no any change in the price. So here price is what? 3 only. Not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's only 3. Because of price is constant, we are saying that price is unchanged. Okay. Change in which factor? Change in the, in this factor. This one. Change in one or some factors. Due to change in this one only, if maybe income changed, maybe your father's income changed, 30,000, 60,000, then your demand will be changed, obviously changed. Pricer is this was a commodity which has sold by 10 rupees per unit. Now also that same commodity sold by 10 rupees per unit. But you are capable to purchase more units because your father's income increased, your purchasing power is increased. Price is same, nothing any change in the price. Only what's changed? Only your income has changed. Due to that reason, your demand will also increase. And this curve, which curve? Curve will shift from D1 to, curve will shift from D1 to D3. And it is known as increase in demand. Again, you can look at here. When price has 3 rupees, that time demand has 3. Correct, friends? When price has 3 rupees, that time demand has also 3 rupees. And then this commodity has 3 units sold. When price is again 3 rupees, but due to increase the income of the consumer, it has this curve move from or shift from D1, D1 to D3, D3, and on that curve, price is also same 3 rupees, but demand is 5 rupees. What is the cost? The cost is due to increase the income of the consumer. Second side, D, if the income decrease from 30,000 rupees to 10,000 rupees, then what will you do? Obviously, your demand will be decreased. So, price is also same again, but demand will be decreased from 3 unit to 1 unit. And curve will shift from D1, D1 to D2, D2. D2, D2. That means what? Left side. This curve will move from the right to left. It is decrease in demand. Any doubt, friends? No. So, it's change due to change in the one or more than one other factors. Other factors, that means what? Consumer's income, taste and preference, future expectation regarding price of related goods, maybe subsidiary or maybe complementary goods. And last one is the trends of the population, size of the population. So due to change, this type of factors, maybe one factor is changed or maybe more than one factors are changing. So demand also will be changed in the market, but price is as usual. Price will be constant, no any change in the price. In that case, demand will be increased, and whenever demand will be increased, the curve will shift from left to right. If demand will be decreased and this all factors change against local demand, at the same price, when demand decreases, is the entire demand curve shift to left side, right to left. Okay, here you can see it has shift from A to B. D1, D1 to D2, D2. It is what? It is decreasing demand. Correct, friends? I hope you understood. Okay. So, friends, you can learn easily this answer, and you can look at it here. Price is same, no any change in the price. Again, it is 3 rupees. Not more than that. Only how much? That means what? Price is constant. So it's known as increase and decrease in demand. Now we can explain same thing by another example, by another. Here it is increase and decrease in demand. What do you mean by the increase and what do you mean by the decrease in demand? Expansion and contraction has different, totally different from this. Now we are discussing the increase and decrease in demand. What do you mean by the increase and decrease in demand? When first one, increase in the first one point we are discussing now. First one point is due to the demand due to change in other factors, price remains constant. Here also we are saying same thing. Demand due to change in other factors, price remains constant. Here it is same point. Because we are considering that demand is changing due to other factors, not due to the price. So we can write it. Second one point is increase in demand occurs when both is purchasing power at the same price and same quantity is purchased by a higher price. So it is what? Increase in demand. Second side, decrease in demand occurs when less is purchased power purchased at the same price or same quantity at lower price. Next one, increase in demand is a result of increase in income, increase in price of substitute goods, decrease in the price of complementary goods, and increase in population. And when goods are in fashion, then demand will be what? Increase of a particular good. Second side, demand decrease because of the, and it is a result of first one, decrease in income, decrease in price of the substitute goods, decrease in the price of complementary goods, decrease in population. Okay. Fifth point, when goods are inflation, that time demand will be increased. When goods are not inflation and go out from the fashion, then demand obviously decreases. These are what, these all are factors, but other than price. Okay, friends. Next one, fourth point is related to when there is an increase in demand, the demand curve shift to right. That means DD curve to D1, D1. This side to that side, that means what? Left to right. Okay, due to increase the demand, curve is shift from left to right, correct? And due to decrease the demand, the curve will shift to the left side. That means what? D1, D1, 2. D2, D2. Okay, this side. That means what? Left to right increase. Right to left decrease. Remember this thing. So curve will shift from D1, D1 to D2, D2 or D0, D0. It's nice decreasing price. We have done, friends, this answer and IMP question for 3 marks. So please, friends, whenever you are going to write this chapter, you have to learn this one. And I said previously also, you have to start, complete this chapter number 3 in your notebook also, and complete this all question answers and learn, because of whenever we will complete this chapter and on the same time your exam will start. Okay, so friends, you complete this chapter properly. Okay, so I have explained this example, another example, this difference between increase and decrease in demand. In this diagram also I have completed increase and decrease in demand. I said that if our curve is moving from left to right, then left to right it is increase, and rightward to left side, then it will be decrease. Okay, left to right it is increase, right to left side it is decrease. Okay, now next point is related, next topic is related to individual demand and market. What do you mean by the individual demand? Individual demand depends what? Individual demand. Friends, individual demand, you have listened so many times this word. If I am demanding this sanitizer, at present I am demanding this sanitizer, it is my individual demand. Because of the corona disease, you know, friends, so many people are purchasing sanitizers. Okay? There are differences. Maybe one person is purchasing an excellent quality sanitizer. Another person is poor, so that person is purchasing low quality sanitizer, whatever. But what a commodity which has demanded by individual person at a given price, at a given particular point of time, that is known as an individual demand. Okay, you can write same meaning which has for demand. Demand, that means individual demand, that means what? Individual demand means a quantity of a commodity which demanded by individual person, and that person is able to get at a given price at a given particular point of time, that is known as individual demand. Correct, friends? Very easy answer. Only you add a word, individual person, and individual word for the demand. Then your answer will be same what we have done in the meaning. Same answer you can write here, only you have to add a word, inducer. And you have to understand that this demand, this commodity demand, if I am demanding, it is inducer demand. Okay, market demand, that is what? More than one person. You, me, your parents, my in-laws, my parents, our full class, related friends, total all 61 students, these all are going to purchase any type of commodity. Okay, at the same price, other persons, my demand will be only 100 ml this sanitizer. Other persons, maybe your demand is 200 ml sanitizer. Another person's demand may be 200 or 500 ml sanitizer, like that. That means what? Price is same, commodity also same, but their demand is different. So if that will be total 100 ml, 200 ml, we are four, for an example, just we are four. So my demand is 100 ml when price is 100 rupees of this sanitizer, so then my demand will be 100 milliliter. Okay, your demand will be 200 milliliter. Your friend's demand is 50 ml only. And your parents' demand is 500 milliliter. And my parents' demand is 1000 milliliter. Then what? We will add this all. And total, whatever we will get total, that will be marketing. I think you got it. So we can say the sum of total. Very easy answer. Individual demand only, you can write that has given in our meaning. You have to add one single word, individual word. Then our answer will be ready. Next is market demand. Market demand is what? The sum of total. Individual demanded of all existing consumers in the market is called market demand at a given price, at a given particular point of time. So, yes, correct, friends? Got it? Next one is tabulation example. In this table, we can get it how on the same price demand is different. Price of a commodity given 10 rupees, 8 rupees, 6 rupees, 4 and 2. Individual demand by Individual demand given here, which is demand by A person, demand by B person, demand by C, demand by A, B, C. So it is individual demand. Suppose I am A person, so it's my demand. You, B, so it's your demand. It's your father's demand. Okay, and this all three will be eight. It will be market. Any confusion? No? So friends, demand here, we are explaining about the individual person. Individual person, that means particular one person related demand at a given price, at a given particular point of time, that is individual demand. If we are, we will sum of this total all, okay, then it will be market demand. Maybe 3%, 4%, 5%, 500, 5,000, 5 lakh or 5 millions. But if we will add this all, then it will be ready market demand of the good. How many people are purchasing this sanitizer from the market? How we can get? That will be market demand. And we will be total of this all, then we will get market demand. What is the demand of this commodity for Meena? Then I will say, yeah, for this price, I have the demand of 1 unit. 100 ml, 1 unit packet, I have a demand. So my demand will be 1. Here, this is the example. 1. Okay? Your example will be 2. For your father's, 3. If you will add this all 3, then it will be 6. So total demand will be, total market demand will be what? 6 units when price is 10 rupees. If price is 8 rupees, my demand will be 2 units. Your demand will be 3 units and your father's demand will be 4. Then it will be total 3, 2, 5, 5 and 4, 9. So total demand will be 9 units. Correct, friends? If price of a commodity is 6 rupees, then my demand is 3 units of this 100 ml packets. Your demand will be 4 units of this 100 ml packets and your father's demand will be 5 units for this 100 ml packets. Next one, if price is 4 rupees, then my demand will be 4 units, your demand will be 5 units, your father's and parents' demand will be 6 units. So total is 15 units when price is 4 rupees of the same color. If price is 2 rupees, then my demand will be 5 units, your demand will be 6 units, your parents' demand will be 7 units and total is what? 18. So 18 is what? Marketing. It is our individual demand. It's your parents' demand. It's your demand and it's my demand. Correct? It is individual. If we will add this all, we will total this all, then we market. In doubt? No. Come to our next topic, friends. Because of it is same type of diagram we have to draw with the help of this table. Very easy, friends. First one you have to draw x-axis and y-axis. You know very well on the x-axis we are showing the On the x-axis, we are showing the demand for the commodity in units. On y-axis, we will show price of a commodity in rupees. So what is the minimum price? That minimum price is 2. Here, it is 2. What is the maximum? 10. So we can write 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. Correct? Then after here, what is the minimum demand? The minimum demand is? Minimum demand is for 8. Minimum demand is A1 and maximum demand is 5. So for me, if I am going to draw this diagram, I will write minimum 1 and maximum will be 5. 1, 2, 5 here and 2 to 10, 2 to 12 for the price. When price is 10 rupees, then demand for this commodity, I have only 1 unit. Then if price is 8 rupees, then my demand is 2 units. If price is 6 rupees, then my demand is 3 units. If price is 4 rupees, then my demand is 4 units. And if price is 2 rupees, then my demand is 5 units. That means what? It is also so showing the inverse relationship between price and demand. That's why this curve slope is also same left to right down. Right, friends? Now next one. It is drawn for the U. In this also 2 to 12 numbers on the OY axis, it is showing the price of a commodity. On the OX axis, it is showing the demand of a commodity in units. 1 to 6. So what is your minimum level? Your minimum demanded has only 2 units. Maximum is 6. So according to that, you will have can draw this diagram here. Correct, friends? For C also same type of diagram. Then after, it is total market demand curve. Total market demand curve, we have to draw with the help of the last total number of the demand, which we have got with the help of this 1 plus 2 plus 3. Then it is 6. 2 plus 3 plus 4. 9. 3 plus 4 plus 5. It is 12. Like that. So according to this table, we have to draw the diagram. According to this table, we will draw the diagram, and this diagram also will be left, right, downwards. Because of in this also, where they are showing that whenever price rise, people are going to purchase less. If prices will fall down, people are going to purchase more and more units. So it is the what? It is the market demand curve. We are also drawing this market demand curve. According to minimum value, maximum value, we can mention the values here. Distance should be appropriate from one to all others. And here, price of a commodity in rupees 2 to 10. And this price is fixed for A, for B, for C, for D, and for E. Okay, A, B, C, D. These are initially points which got by the society, which got by this interact point. Interact point, that means what? Price and demand. These both are here. On the A point, price is 10 rupees, demand is 5 units. When price is on the B point, when price is 8 rupees, demand is 10 units. When price is on the C point, when price is 6 rupees, then demand is 12 units. If price is 2 rupees, then demand is last one, near 220. That means what? 70. So this type of demand is going to increase due to decrease the price. And this one topic we have completed. I hope you all have understood, all you got it. If you have any doubt, any query, any problem, personally message me, share with me. I will solve your doubts. Okay, friends. Bye. We will meet again in the next video.